Heritage.
Nice to meet you.
Did Kara tell you I was going to stop by?
She did not, no.
She didn't.
No.
I love it when that happens. Thank you, Kara. Well, I'm sorry. I apologize. I'm the one that's responsible for talking to all the families out here in Stover, in Columbia, about cancer and heart attacks and accidents. I caught up with George and Stephanie. I don't know if you know the Zimneys.
I do.
And I caught up with Karen. I promise you I'd stop by and catch up with you. I'm sorry. I only get just a few minutes to actually spend with each family. Do you have a place where we can sit down?
Yeah, come on in.
Now, how long have you guys lived out here in Columbia?
We've lived here about 5 years.
Okay. Yeah. Well, you probably know a ton of people that I've talked to out here. Tell me who you recognize.
Oh gosh, I'm so at ya. I know Cindy and Ryan.
Oh yeah?
Yeah.
How do you know Cindy?
Go to church with Cindy and Ryan.
Right.
Yeah. I know Rihanna.
Yeah.
She's from, I know her way back in the day.
Right. Right. Did you guys grow up together? You and Rihanna?
We did, okay. Yeah.
She's a little bit older than you though.
Yeah, it's small town. So
okay.
Kind of know everybody. Kelly and Dusty,
sure.
Know them pretty well just from being in the area.
Everybody knows Dusty.
Yeah. Amber know her pretty well too. We grew up with her as well.
Gotcha.
Yeah.
Who else?
Let's see here. I know names, a lot of the names look very familiar.
Sure.
But yeah, those are the only ones that really stick out to me.
Sure, sure. Now what about on this page? Do you know Jeremy and Melissa? I know everybody calls Jeremy J Dub. Do you know Jeremy and Melissa?
I know of Jeremy and Melissa, yeah.
Yeah. And then now what about Luke and Kyle? I don't know if you know Luke. He works up here at the prison.
Okay.
If you know Luke, Melissa and Jeremy, Hanson, Jody and Sandra. You guys have lived down here for about 5 years. Y'all know a ton of people.
Yeah.
You know a ton of people. Let me tell you this. I definitely don't want to take much of your time.
Okay.
All I do, Chelsea, is talk with families about cancer and heart attacks and accidents. And I know that's not a pleasant subject to talk about.
Yeah.
But it affects a ton of people out here in this area. You know, without getting anywhere personal with you guys, who's probably the closest person to you that's ever had to deal with anything? You know what I mean? Back surgeries, neck surgeries, car accidents. I mean, even something as major as heart attack, stroke, or cancer.
Yeah, heart attack and stroke that runs in my family. It seems like cancer runs a lot in my husband's family. So.
I'm sorry to hear that. Now, with you, with the heart problems and stroke, who's probably the closest person?
My grandfather.
Your grandfather?
Yeah.
I'm sorry to hear that. Now, how long ago was this?
He's been dealing with heart problems for as long as I've known, you know, been able to.
So maybe even in his 50s when it started, or is
I'm sure.
Maybe younger than that?
Probably.
So he was young.
Yeah.
Very young. I'm sorry. But he's a survivor, of course.
Oh, yeah.
He's doing fine now.
Well,
yeah. Is that the first time it ever hit in your family? Is just with your grandfather?
No. It kind of runs in that side of the family.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Gotcha. And that's on your mom's side? That's on your dad's side?
It's my mom's side.
That's your mom's side.
Yeah.
Okay, gotcha. And then you said on your husband's side of the family, that's mainly cancer. Not really any heart problems.
No.
At all. Who's the closest person?
His mom had breast cancer.
Is she?
She's fine. She's a survivor.
She's a survivor?
Yeah.
Raise
her
up.
Yeah.
Oh, that's awesome. How long ago was this?
This was probably 7 years ago or so.
About 7 years ago. So it hasn't been that long then?
No, not too long.
How long did she fight with
it? It was probably 3 years that she, you know, had to go through all of it.
She was a fighter.
Yeah.
Did she do surgeries, treatments? I mean, did she do radiation and chemo or no?
She had all of it.
She did all of that.
Yeah.
She was a fighter.
Yeah, she's doing good though.
Well, you'll definitely appreciate what we do. Basically, what we do is the opposite of a health or a life insurance. I imagine either through your work or through you guys probably have health insurance, life insurance, dental, vision, and all that type of disability, all that type of stuff.
Yeah, we get that through his work.
Okay, fantastic. Yeah. What we do is, and that's the same way it is with Kara, by the way, all that comes through the hospital with her.
Okay.
What we do is the exact opposite of that. And what I mean by that is simply if something happens to you, if someone has a young, someone has your kid, whether it be something small, burning your room, stitches, broken bones, all the way up to something major, maybe a car accident, back surgery, neck surgery, the big three that scare everybody, Chelsea, is heart attack, stroke, or cancer. What we do is we pay that cash directly to you. You can spend that on a doctor or hospital if you owe them some money, if your insurance will cover everything. You can spend it on booze or going to Disney World if you like Disney World. Most people, they need to keep the lights on. They need to keep food on the table. They need to keep gas in the truck. Does that make any sense at all?
Yeah,
does that make any sense at all?
Yeah.
I can't promise you that it's going to make sense to y'all. You know, I gave Karen my word, I'd sit down and show it to you. But if it's all right with you, I'm just going to give you, I'm just going to kind of give you a short version, if that's all right with you. Now this basically just says that cancer can happen. Of course, you know that. Science has proved 91% of cancer is not hereditary. They say that mainly it comes from right there, which is everything we eat, drink, and breathe. You know, the good news is 6 out of 10 people beat it. It's not the death sentence that it used to be. There's definitely, and whether it be Stover, you know, whether it be here in Columbia, there is a ton of cancer survivors out here. I mean, your mother-in-law, obviously, I mean, she beat cancer. She's a cancer survivor. The bad news is it's just very, very expensive. That's not a secret. I'm not telling you something you don't know. The United States, they spend billions fighting with it. They break this into two completely different costs.
Okay.
One of them's obvious. The doctors, the hospital, the medical charges. This is basically what health insurance takes care of. You know, obviously it's through his work with J-Dub. He's got all that through the prison. You know, and so that covers this. They don't send me out here to talk to families about that. It's more the indirect cost. This is a lot bigger portion than that. It's just not as obvious. Whenever it comes to knee surgeries, when it comes to back problems, when it comes to heart attacks or strokes or cancer, what's the first thing that pops into your head as far as the indirect cost?
Travel is a big one. I know my mother-in-law was traveling back and forth to treatments, so that was a big one for her and the family.
Sure. Did she live here in Columbia, or she lived in Stover?
She lives here in Columbia.
She lives in Columbia. Now, yeah. Where was she going for most of her treatments?
She was going to the Mayo Clinic.
Wow.
So
Rochester.
She was traveling.
Yeah. Wow. Good God. Well, definitely. I mean, whether it's the prison, whether it's the oil field, you know, whether it's a teacher, as good as your benefits are they ever going to put a tank of gas in your truck?
No, not at all.
It's not going to happen. You know, what else?
Oh, gosh, there's several things. I would just say some of the things that, you know, the hospital or the doctors don't cover is like wigs and things that people don't really think about. There's also mean food we gotta eat as well.
That's right. Yeah. What else?
She wasn't working whenever, I mean, she was not retired at that point, so she was still working, but couldn't work while
couldn't
she was
work.
Going through it. So, wages as well.
Absolutely. Damn. You probably understand this better than most people that I've talked to. A lot of people say, JJ, I don't have a clue. You know, I would say that's probably more than normal, honestly. I would say, Chuck, if y'all understand just this one page, you're going to understand why Melissa and Jada, you know, why Luke and Kylie, why Tom and April, why so many different people out here have picked this up. You know, the number one indirect cost is always going to be the out-of-pocket. That's driving back and forth. First thing you mentioned, driving back and forth, food, lodging, childcare. The good thing is, you guys know so many people out here in Columbia, you're not going to be paying for childcare. I mean, you go drop them off at your mom's, it is mom's, something like that. The insurance limitations, the co-payments, deductibles, and medications, most of that's going to be covered by his insurance. I mean, y'all will have very little out of pocket. The one that gets everybody is the uncovered charge. Everybody thinks they have good health insurance until they have to use it.
Yeah.
And then they get a bill here for $2,300 that the insurance didn't cover, or that maybe your portion of it was only $2,300. Then they get another bill here for $400 and another bill for $800. Before you know it, it's $5,000 out of our pocket. And that's with good health insurance. That's with good health insurance. The living expenses, that's the housing and the auto, utilities, and the food. Tell me, when are they going to stop sending a utility bill?
Never.
If you figure it out, let me know.
Yeah, I know.
And then even if it's just a small amount of lost income, you know, being a truck driver, being a nurse, you guys make a boatload of money. Which is great. You know, I mean, you've earned that. The bad thing is, if you get hurt or you get sick, if something happened to him and he gets hurt and he gets sick, you just missed a boatload of what?
Cash. It's our income.
It works the same. I mean, it works the same way. When somebody just loses a little bit of income, or they miss just a week or two of work, how long does it take before most people have to dip in or kind of start using their savings?
Yeah, it's not long. I would say about a month and a half, and that's it.
Most of the time, definitely. Within about 6 weeks. Now tell me this though, when do you think, Chelsea, when do you think most people find out about these type of calls?
When they have to, when they're going through it.
Absolutely.
Definitely.
Now, in a million years, and I want you to tell me the truth. In a million years, did you ever think it was going to happen to your grandma?
No, not at all.
Yeah.
Thought he was healthy, works out all the time.
Yeah. And then your mother-in-law with cancer. Now you said that was just 7 years ago.
Yeah.
Did you see that coming?
Completely out of the blue. Didn't see it coming at all.
Yeah. And tell me this, I want you to be honest. Do you ever think it's going to happen to one of your kids?
I hope not. But you never know.
Yeah. I hope not.
Yeah.
Absolutely. The last person we think it's going to happen to, it's not our grandparents. It's not our mom and dad. It's really not even our kids. And the last person that's going to happen to is Chelsea. I mean, that's just the way that we always think.
Yeah.
You know, in reality, and I'm not talking about long term, what your mother-in-law went through with 3 years. You've heard of people going through it 4 years.
Mm-hmm.
Some people go through it 7 or 8 years. You know, maybe they beat it and it comes back. You know, something like that. That to me is an extreme case. Okay, let's lowball. Let's be real. Let's just say, you know, it's different for every single person I talk to. But just for 6 months to a year, if you're going through a knee surgery, you can be out for 6 months. You know, a back surgery, heart problems and cancer may be longer than that. But let's just say 6 months to a year that you're either sick or physically you're unable to work, or you just choose not to work so that you can be there with each other, be there with your kids. Just for the two of y'all, which of these indirect costs do you feel like is going to affect you guys the most?
Definitely loss of income. And it just snowballs into all the others as well.
Yeah.
Yeah, living expenses, those are always there, so we'll go into that as well.
Yeah. Every person that I talk to is going to be a little bit different. You know, when I talk with Clayton Simmons, he's going to be different from Christelle. You know, my family, of course, is going to be different from y'all. Why do you say for you that the lost income is going to affect you more than these other three?
Well, just if I wasn't working for, let's say, right at 6 months, that's a good chunk of money, you know. And I mean, I'm the breadwinner of the family, so.
Sure. Yeah, as a nurse, yeah, naturally.
Yes, it's a good chunk.
Yeah. That's really the only reason that so many people out here have picked this up.